Well, I got to ask you. I mean, prior to signing this new deal, your troll level 1,000 on social media. Your game has been off the charts lately. Got the internet talking, speculating that maybe Randy Orton was looking to dip his toe into another sort of water. Was there any truth to that, or were you just having fun?
Social media, like, I'm still figuring it out. My wife and I did an Instagram live story the other day, and I still can't wrap my head around why you would want to do that. I don't think it was live. I guess you can do it live or not, but it, live mics and Randy Orton don't mix well, but to say the least. But yeah, I was just having fun. I'm not in the WWE bubble as much as I've been for almost the last two decades, and I'm learning to appreciate other styles a little more instead of just quickly seeing something that isn't how I would do it or isn't how I would sell it. So it's good in its own way. It's good. You can't please everybody, but yeah, I guess this might be upsetting for some people, but I never really saw myself leaving WWE. I started here. My father was here. My grandfather wrestled for Vince's father. You know what I mean? There's a lot of history here. And yeah, I could have left and I could have come back. But man, why? I've made it here this long, and I really shouldn't have. Against all odds, I'm still here. And Vince and I were able to come to terms. And like I said at the beginning of the interview, I am happy. And that's, to me, it was about getting to a point where I'm happy and what I'm doing in my body, the amount of time that I'm gone from my family. In the end, it's all going to be worth it. And that's where I'm at right now. So I'm definitely happy being a WWE superstar.
If you want to hear more of the dulcet tones of my sultry voice, go to wherever you get your podcasts and subscribe to WWE After the Bell. Do it right now.